So, welcome to module 2.4. So, in this module 2.4, we are going to talk about certain logic circuits. So, we will talk about three circuits. One is called the half adder, then a full adder, and an adder. Okay. So, we will see these three circuits. Now, these three we'll be using it as a part of our hardware simulation also. Now, what is an half adder? I am adding two bits, and what is the answer I could get? So, there are two bits A comma B. When I add 0 and 0, the answer is 0. When I add 0 and 1, the answer is 1. 1 and 0, 1. So, 0 plus 0, 0 plus 1. But when I add 1 and 1, what do you get? I get 1 and 1 is 2, 2 is 0, 1. So, I get a 0 and another 1 as a carry. So, these 4 bits are called sum bits, and the remaining things are carry bits. Okay. It is also quite useful for our reading if I put the carry bits first and the sum bit next. So, this will give me 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. Right. So basically, this gives us this interesting table A, B, carry, sum, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. Right? Now, if you look at how A, B and C are working, you see these two are inputs and these two are outputs. If you just view this part of the truth table alone for A, B and C, you will understand that C is equal to A and B, means it is an AND gate. This is exactly the truth table of an AND gate. AND gate was introduced in the previous module, right? This is a truth table. Now, if you look at A, B and S, A, B and S alone, you will now understand that this is a XOR gate. So, A, B, XOR, we have done the XOR also in the previous module. So, this is the sum, right. So, what does, so this circuit is nothing but what we call as an half adder. So, what does an half adder do? It takes two bits and it adds and gives a carry bit and a sum bit. The carry bit plus sum bit put together will give you the result of this addition, right. Now, what is the circuit involved? A and B are the input bits, C and S are the output bits. C is A and B, so use an AND gate to generate the carry and use an XOR gate to generate the sum. Now, for all people who are just getting to understand computing, please understand that this is how logic gates, namely AND gate, XOR gate that we introduced earlier, is now used for doing arithmetic computation. So, this is how the logic now maps on to arithmetic, or arithmetic maps on to logic. That is a correct way of putting. So, I am doing an arithmetic. I am basically trying to add two bits, and these two bits I am mapping it on to two logic gates here, right. So this is how an half adder is constructed. Now, when we do addition, so when, what did we do? 78 plus 56, 8 plus 6, 14. I take one carry above here, 7 plus 1, 8 plus 5, 13. I take another carry and bring it here. So, what is after all an addition? This is an addition with 0 as a carry. This is an addition with 1 as a carry. So, normally when we add, we do not add 2 digits here. Actually, we try and add 3 digits at every time, right? Because carry is also one digit. So, this is in the case of binary, in the case of decimal. The same thing is true in the case of binary. So, if I am looking at adding 1100 plus 10 sorry, I'll make it a little more interesting. 1101 plus 1111. So one. So initially, this 0 is the carry. Now I'll do the computation with red. 0 is the carry. So 0 plus 1 plus 1 is, I get some bit 0, 1. 1 plus 1 is 2, that is some bit 0, 1. 1 plus 1 is 2, the some bit is 0. 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3, so 1, and this is the carry. So that means every time I add A, B and a carry in, or and what I generate out is every time I add 0, 1, 1, I generate a sum bit, I generate a sum bit and a carry bit. The 0, 1, 1 generated a 0 and a 1. This 1, 0, 1 now generated a 0 which is a sum bit and a carry bit which is 1. This 1, 1, 0 generated a sum bit which is 0 and a carry bit that is 1. 1, 1, 1 actually generated a sum bit and a carry bit which is 1. So I give 3 inputs and I get 2 outputs which is the sum and the carry out, right. So this is basically the full adder circuit. So now, so how do we design the full adder circuit? Let us go. So we will draw the complete truth, this is called the truth table. So I have A, B, C in, C out and sum. So I will put 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. 0 plus 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 1 plus 1 is 2, 1 plus 0 plus 0 is 1, sorry, 1 plus 1, 0 plus 1 is 2, 1 plus 1 plus is 2, 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3. Okay. So when we look at this entire thing, you will find out that this one of the interesting thing is your carry is 1 when either A and B, your carry is 1, carry is 1, that is carry means C out is 1 when 1, either A comma B both are 1 or A comma C in both are 1 or B comma C in both are 1. One of these three conditions have to be satisfied. So let us see when the carry is 1. The carry is 1 when B and C are both are 1, or A and C are both are 1, or A and B are both are 1. Since it is R, it can be A and B or B and C. Here this condition is also satisfied. So this is the thing. So I can write C out as A B plus A C in plus B C in. So now if you just use this is and A and B or A C in or B C in. So the circuit for this would be A C in okay. So you can to construct this circuit both the half adder and the full adder, you can use the half adder, the AND and XOR gate that you have done as part of project 1. Again I repeat, please complete project 1 before doing this, then only you will you will appreciate what we have done and you can map things. So please spend that 1 hour or 1.5 hours and do that project one. Otherwise, this will not be that effective, right? So this is, after all, we are asking you to spend 20 hours totally for this course and you learn lot of computer science. So I think it's worth it. So kindly do that project one. Again, I repeat here. So it's very important. So once you have done project one, you will appreciate how to generate the circuit. It's going to be very straightforward. You have two outputs and you know you have done so many mux, demux, etc. there. So just use an AND gate and XOR gate which you have done already as a part of project one. Use it to generate an half adder. Similarly, when you are doing a full adder, so this is very easy, right? You just basically use three AND gates again, and you have already done. AND was done using NAND. So that AND gate which is in turn realized as NAND as you see, and then you can use this three-way OR. So multi-way gates we have seen, this is a three-way OR. So you can do this to realize the circuit. Now interestingly, we will also find out that sum will make number of ones in each row even, right? So let us take row 1. How many ones are there? 0 ones are there. Sum also remains to be 0 to keep the whole thing 0. In the second thing, how many ones are there in the second row that I am seeing here? How many ones are there? There is one here. So the sum, so do not consider C out. Just in the among the inputs, right? there is one one. So sum becomes one to make the total thing two. Similarly, in the third row we have one one, so the sum also becomes one to make it two. In the fourth row we have two ones, so the sum becomes zero to make it even. The fifth one there is one one, so it is. And the seventh one there are already 2, 8 sorry 6th and 7th there are already 2, so this remains at 0, and the 7th one there are 3 ones, so this becomes 1, right. So how do you realize this? You basically realize it as A XOR B. A XOR B will again try to make it even. Right. If you take the XOR gate A B, this is the XOR of B. So 0 0 is 0, 0 1 is 1, 1 0 is 1, 1 1 is 0. So the output of this XOR will try to see that the number of ones in every row is even. Right. So I will say A XOR B, and this I will take it to XOR C. And this is sum. So when this will be 1, this will be 1 if this is 0 and this is 1, or this is 1 and this is 0. If this is 0 and this is 1, that is case 1. If this is 0 and this is 1, that means A and B have even number of ones. And C is having an extra one, C is having extra one. So the total number is odd number of ones, and hence the answer sum will make it even. And similarly, if this is 1, the other reason is if this is 1 and this is 0, there you will find out if this is 1, then A and B has odd number of ones, that is one of them is 1 and C is 0. So that means out of A, B, C there are odd number of ones, and so the sum will become sum is extra 1 which will make it even. Okay. So your sum bit is nothing but A XOR B, that output fed to C to give this. Now using the XOR gate, AND gate and OR gate of our previous lecture, you will be in a position very easily to construct a full adder. And what will the full adder do? It will take 3 bits and generate a sum bit and a carry bit. Now with this, how do you construct a n bit adder or 4 bit adder? So we will talk of n bit adder, but for a specific case, let us say we want to do a 4 bit adder. So, take full adder. So, what are the 4 bits to be added? 2 4 bits, let me take A4, A3, A2, A1 and B4, B3, B2, B1. So, this is full adder. Let me say full adder. I will make 4 full adders, right. So, 4 full adders and here I will put A1, B1 and 0 as input. So, I will get a sum bit and a carry bit, let me call it C1, which goes here, and A2, B2, I will get a sum bit and another carry bit, which goes here. Then I put A3, B3, I will get another sum bit, another carry bit which goes here. Then I put A4, B4, so I get another sum bit and a carry bit. Okay. Now, C4, these are the 5 bits. This is the answer, right. So, automatically now I have constructed a circuit which will add 2 4 bit numbers, right. I can keep extending it the same thing to n bits. And please note that this exactly does how our addition happens. So, we gave some example of an addition, right, in our previous thing, 1101 plus 1011. So, let us say I want to do 1101. So, the A is 1101 and B was some 1011. 1101 plus 1011. So, 1 and 1 I add, 1 and 1, so I get 0, this goes as 1, 0 1 1, 1 and 1, this is 1, okay. 0 1 1 will give me again 0, 1 goes here, 1 0 1 will give me again 0, 1 goes here, 1 1 1 will give me 1, 1. So, the answer is, sorry, this is 0, 11000. This is what happens here, 1 plus 1 is 0, 1 plus 1 is 0, 1 plus 1 is 0. Right. So, this is how you construct a full adder from, construct an n bit adder from n full adders. We have constructed a 4 bit adder with 4 full adders. In the project 2 that we will be doing as a part, you may construct a 16 bit adder also. Okay. So, in this module we have seen 3 circuits, namely full adder, half adder, full adder and an adder, and this you will be asked to do as a project, right. So, we will continue with an ALU, we will be constructing an ALU in the next module. Thank you.